Karis, I've just interviewed the old guard of British politics. Would you see yourself as the new guard?
Yeah, I'd like to think so. I'd like to think that I have the energy and enthusiasm and the honesty that British politics needs now. I think that's what people are crying out for. So I think there's really a huge amount of scope for a new generation to come into politics and to change it.
First of all, how's your campaign been going in Thurrock?
It's been going really well. This week I've been really delighted to unveil a range of accessible campaigning materials for people with learning disabilities and people with visual impairments. So at the moment I'm really pushing promoting those materials to make sure that people can really make the most out of them in Thurrock.
What sort of feedback are you getting on the street at the moment?
Really interesting feedback actually. We're finding that a lot of people who are normally Labour voters, they were big fans of Andrew McKinley, but they're also disillusioned. And they're not really convinced by Gordon Brown, and they're not happy about his track record. At the same time, a lot of those people can't bring themselves to vote Conservative. And they're worried about, of course, obviously the Conservative funding stories that we've been seeing. And they're looking for an alternative, and that's what I'm there for. I'm there to provide an alternative and a change and something that really people can believe in now.
Mr. McKinley just said to me that it's very probable there could be a hung parliament. Would you go along with that?
I think it's looking quite likely if you look at the polls at the moment. Not really wanting to speculate about what will happen, but it does seem that plans have been put into place to be able to deal with that by Parliament, should that be the event. It will be very interesting if that does happen. It's not something that's happened for about 30 years, I believe. So.
He also hinted that the electoral system as it stands is wrong. Would if the Liberals came to power, would you, is that something you'd change?
Absolutely. I think one of the first things, if this did happen, would be to really push for a system of proportional representation and a real system that really works, so that people can feel that their votes do count. At the moment, people feel that whichever way they vote, it's not going to make a difference. Unless we get rid of the first-past-the-post system, unfortunately, people don't feel they have a voice.
We interviewed Jackie Doyle-Pryce yesterday, the enemy camp, shall we say. She seems to be finding her campaign very much on a national front. What angle are you taking? Are you taking a national side or are you taking a local side?
I think it absolutely has to be both. I think different people want different things. Some people want to know about what we'll do locally. Other people are much more concerned about the national picture. David Cameron once said that if you want to see how a Tory government would work, look at any local council. And I think the reason why Jackie is obviously going for that stance is because of the Tories' trouble recently on our local council.
What should you be elected? What would be one of the first things you'd like to change or fight a cause in Thurrock?
And certainly one of the things I'm really interested in is healthcare in the area. We do have a proposed new community hospital for Greys. I'm concerned that that actually provides what people are calling for and it has the services that people really feel they need. Secondly, I'm very worried about the level of skills and qualifications in Thurrock. There are new job opportunities opening up in the area with the Development Corporation and so on, but there seems to be very low level of skills and qualifications. I think one of the lowest in the east of England. And that worries me that young people in the area won't be able to take up those opportunities. We do have an excellent example of some of the local schools really improving their standards. And I want to make sure that's rolled out across the borough and the constituency.
What are your plans now? You're going to have a very busy 30 days. Where are you getting up to?
Most weekends, well, every weekend actually from now, we'll be out around and about. We'll be in Greys doing a street stall in the market every Saturday. Also up in South Rockendon, we'll be out in Tilbury, we'll be out in Purfleet, we'll be all over the constituency. We're going to be doing a mixture of street stalls, which puts us right on the street where people doing their shopping can just pop by, say hello and find out what we're about. Of course, we'll be doing the usual door knocking as well. So there's plenty of opportunities for people to come out and find me.
Karis, we wish you the best luck in your campaign.
Thank you.